Hello?
Is this Lord Stewart?
Is this Patrick Stewart? Who am I talking to?
This is Colonel Sanders, Lord Stewart.
Well, you needn't call me Lord Stewart. I am Sir Pat, but you needn't call me that either, really.
Oh, well, I may have misunderstood the protocols there.
You can just call me Patrick. You said your name is Colonel Sanders. Are you the Colonel Sanders?
Yes, I am the Colonel Sanders. Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, I'm very honored by your call. What can I do for you, Colonel?
Well, I notice that you are, of course, a well-considered Shakespearean actor. And you have a lot of respect for Shakespeare's writing and poetry and limericks and things like that.
I'm unaware that you wrote limericks, but yes, I am a great fan of the Bard. And in fact, I spent a good deal of the pandemic reciting all of Shakespeare's sonnets, which was a great exercise and helped me pass the time. And a lot of people told me that they got a lot out of it. Did you consume my content?
No, I didn't, I confess, but I am aware that you're a Shakespearean actor and from your great career, and that's why, frankly, I come to you today to share something with you that I hope you'll want to perhaps consider.
Oh, well, please be my guest. What can I do you for, as they say?
Well, I've written a little sonnet here, and I just wanted to share it with you and see if you felt like it was something you might be able to get behind and present in some way. Yeah.
So you've written a sonnet yourself?
Yes, I have. I believe I followed all the rules. I looked it up on Google, and there's quite a lot of things you got to make sure you get right.
Oh, yes, there is a standard form, but I mean, you know, it really doesn't matter. The most important thing is, are you speaking from the heart?
Well, in this case, I got that right. Would you have a minute right now? Could I read it to you over the phone?
Why not? Yes, of course.
All right, here we go. Shall I compare thee to a chicken leg?
Oh, dear.
Thou art as tender and as succulent. Thy skin possesses chicken's golden glow and needs not feathers plucked to make it fair.
Mm.
Your presence satisfies and makes one smile, as does beholding thighs and breasts deep fried.
Oh.
Mere memory of thee brings eagerness to spend some time with you in my embrace, and whether in some meadow at a picnic, or at a tailgate party in a parking lot, or pulled forth from a bucket fresh and warm, at dinner time you do not disappoint. And whilst the memory of thee doth linger still, I lick my fingers and relive thy thrill.
Well, that's an extraordinary piece of writing.
Thank you. Well, like you said, it's written from the heart, so you know, I meant every word of it.
Well, I could tell that.
So what do you say, Sir Pat? I'm not sure where sonnets are performed these days. How exactly does that work?
Well, I mean, sonnets are performed in any number of ways, as part of a larger theatrical production or just a one-off, as I've done on Twitter and on social media. But I feel this particular poem of yours is one that I think would be best expressed by you, frankly,
because
it's your brand, if you will. It's really not mine.
Oh,
Shakespeare is. Chicken is not.
Oh, that's disappointing.
Yes, but I don't mean to disparage the quality of your poem. It's a lovely sonnet and very heartfelt, and I'm sure somewhere there's a very appreciative audience for it.
Yeah, that's what I was figuring, and so I thought I'd go to the master, you know, and see if it would be something you'd be willing to take a shot at. But I understand if you don't feel it aligns with your...
My brand.
Your brand, exactly.
Yeah. Well, it's been lovely chatting.
Yes, it has indeed. Thank you so much, Sir Pat, and thank you for taking the time. I do appreciate it.
You're very welcome, Colonel, and thank you for sharing that lovely poem with me. I really, really do appreciate it. Bye-bye.
Say, I might write another one with biscuits and gravy.
I lick my fingers and relive thy thrill.